One of the most exciting carbon offset projects to emerge globally is happening right now in the forests of the Himalayas.
Himalayan Community Carbon Project really focuses on the Himalayan watershed, which is very crucial to South Asia because it regulates the flow of water and soil downstream.
Deforestation and climate change are threatening people's lives and livelihoods. Reforestation is vital for our future. Rain falls on mountains and flows downstream. Trees and soil act like a sponge. Without the forest, rain comes down and washes straight off the mountains, taking soil with it, causing flooding and droughts. Climate change is making the situation worse as the rainy season is getting shorter and more intense. Restoring the forest protects this watershed, and as the trees grow, the forest ecosystem takes carbon from the atmosphere. Globally, this is a carbon project. Restoring the Himalayan forest helps reduce carbon levels and global warming. For South Asia, this is about reducing floods and droughts. And locally, this is about people's vulnerability and improved livelihoods. The strength of this project is in the well-organized village communities. People are working cooperatively and equally. The project is managed by Rupantaran, an experienced team who work as a not-for-profit organization with a long track record in community forestry.
If you ask anyone in the world where the best community forestry is practiced, it's in Nepal.
The communities are working to improve and restore the forests to maximize carbon uptake and forest products.
The most inspirational aspect of this project for me are the communities and the people. These are exceptionally well organized communities.
Rupantaran works with the village development committees and the forest user groups, educating people about climate change and improved forest management. The villages are not just well organized. Working with the forest is a part of everyday life, and improved management includes thinning to maximize carbon uptake and to get firewood and timber.
हाम्रो वनबाट हामी उपभोक्ताहरूले काठ दाउरा घाँस अनि जंगलका जडीबुटीहरू अनि पात अनि अरु गाईवस्तुलाई स्याउला यता इत्यादि अरु हुन्छ.
Keeping cows and goats from grazing in the forests is helping the forest regenerate naturally.
This goat farming is helping to protect the forest by not letting the goats go into the forest for grazing.
हामी बोट बिरुवाहरू लगाएछौँ अनि घाँस काट्छौँ हाल्छौँ र वनलाई त्यति नष्ट छैन.
The most vulnerable villagers are getting financial help to create their own basic income generating activities. The villagers use wood for cooking, so to further reduce pressure on the forest, simple improved cook stoves are being installed. These use half the firewood and are smoke free.
There's a large part of this country that's been untouched by this kind of program. And really, the next stage with Rupantaran at the helm is to try and get into those districts.
For the Himalayan Community Carbon Project to really succeed, the businesses and individuals need to purchase the Plant Vivo Certified Carbon Credits.
If you're a company and you want to send out a message which is about climate change and your ethical stance, then investing in these communities where you're building their capacity, building their resilience, can only be good for your product.
It would conserve a very important ecosystem and also will benefit from improving the livelihoods of really vulnerable Himalayan communities.
The Himalayan Community Carbon Project is ready for investment. If you would like to carbon balance your organization or product with Plan Vivo carbon credits from this project, get in touch with Sea Level.